الله نور السماوات والأرض مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور.
Have you ever thought, why does Allah give the ones who have patience a reward without account, without limit? Because only you know how much you have gone through. People from all over the world struggle different ways. Right now, as I'm speaking, wallahi, every one of us, our hearts should be bleeding for those who are struggling and suffering across the globe. There are people driven out of their homes. There are people whose homes were burnt. And I cannot even begin to mention the names of the places where the people are suffering, because it's no longer one or two places. It is more like so many places, I can't even say the names. Where should I start? If I start in Rohingya, what happens to Syria? What happens to Afghanistan and Pakistan? What happens to all of us? What happens to those in Africa who are struggling? What happens to those who are suffering at the hands of their own brothers and sisters who are Muslims? So much suffering is happening across the globe. People say, why is Allah doing this? My brother, my sister, Allah is the creator. We are the ones who are doing the evil on earth. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس ليذيقهم بعض الذي عملوا لعلهم يرجعون. Allah says there is chaos and corruption on earth that has become rampant. Why? What's the reason Allah gives? There is chaos on earth and on sea, on land and on sea. Chaos, corruption. Why? Because of what man has done himself. Man has done himself. Who is killing who here? Who is harming who here? Man is doing it. Don't blame Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, in order for them to taste a little bit of their deeds, what they are doing themselves, we will let them taste it, so that they can turn back to us, so that they can come back to us. From this verse we learn that when calamity strikes, what are we supposed to be doing? Getting closer to Allah. Get closer to Allah, and Allah will grant you success. Some people die of sickness, others they die healthy because they are killed by someone. Some die by what we call accident, yet it's just an excuse, something for you and I to blame. But the bottom line is, you don't know when you are going. So cut your bad ways, cut your bad habits, become a better person, turn to Allah, fulfill your salah. It might be the last salah you are going to fulfill. We have watched the video clips on WhatsApp where there was an imam who led Salatul Asr in the masjid. He turned around and he's reading his adhkar and he fell. Someone says, mashallah, blessed death. Wallahi, it is a blessed death. We watched another clip of a muadhin who, before Salatul Fajr, before he could call the adhan, he was reading Quran in the masjid waiting for the time and he dropped dead. Subhanallah, Malakul Maut came to visit him. The angel of death visited him and took his soul away while the Quran was open. Suratul An'am, he was reading. I even saw the page. And you know what? He was gone. People came for Salatul Fajr, but the muadhin is gone. They said, blessed death, blessed death. Okay, I'll give you a third example. There was another qari who was busy reading in the public, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. And he dropped in Indonesia. He dropped and he passed away. People said, blessed death, mashallah. Another example, someone in Medina Munawwara, in sujood, in salah, and they didn't get up. People all made a circle around him. They started taking photos for the internet. Blessed death. My brothers and sisters, don't be deceived by shaitan. You know why? Don't be deceived by shaitan. Shaitan makes you say, blessed death, blessed death, blessed death. That part, yes, it's correct. But beyond that, what did you do about it? Nothing. We just passed the WhatsApp message to everyone and we said, Inna lillah, may Allah give him Jannah. What about you? People say, may Allah give me a similar death. But you are not there for Salatul Fajr. You are not there before Salatul Fajr. You haven't read the Quran. You are not there in sujood. You don't even make sujood for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you have the same death? Now, on a lighter note, one day I was talking to young people and I said, make dua that you pass away in sujood. So they all said, Ameen, loudly say Ameen. Ameen. May Allah grant us death in sujood. Wallahi, it's a blessed death. So the youngsters came along and they were saying, you know what? But these youngsters, they don't read salah. So I said, why are you not reading salah? You want to die in sujood, but you are not fulfilling salah. Look at that. It's ironic, isn't it? You know what one young man said, and people have answers. Nowadays, they have a quick answer, very fast in thinking, you know, very quick. He says, but if I don't want to read salah right now, I want to die in sujood, yes. But when I'm ready to die, I'll start reading salah so that I can die in sujood. So, come on, my brother. My brother, what is it? Who are you fooling? How can you say that? You understand what his point is? He's trying to say, I'm going to keep on making dua, Allah take me in sujood, when I'm not going to be there, because one day when I'm okay, now I will go. It's similar to those whom, when Hajj is farad on you, you need to go. You can't say, I still need to sin for a few years. No. Show gratitude to Allah. I will go, you have blessed me. Now my life is going to become more organized. I'm going to be a responsible, mature Muslim. Because my brothers and sisters, enough is enough. How much are you going to sin? How long are you going to continue in that sin of yours? What do you want? Do you want Allah to take you away while you are sinning? If that is the case, wallahi, it's a loss. It's enough. Discipline your life. Cut out the sin. That is gratitude to Allah. You are showing gratefulness for what you have. It's not difficult. Do you know for sins you have to pay? But to obey Allah's instruction, you don't have to pay. Subhanallah. We come to the masjid free. Go to the nightclub, you pay. What else? You want to have alcohol, you got to pay. You drink water, free. What else? Subhanallah. You want to go for drugs, you got to pay. You want to breathe fresh air, you don't have to pay. Subhanallah. Look at this. Everything you think about, you want to read Quran, subhanallah, you'll get a madrasa, they will teach you free. But you want to do evil and you want to do something bad, you're going to have to pay for it. The angels who are standing at the doors of Jahannam will ask a question to those coming into Jahannam in groups, saying, did Allah not send you someone from amongst you to remind you about this and to ask you to change your ways and habits, etc., etc., etc.? Did Allah not send you someone to read His verses to you? How come you are here? They will say, yes, Allah did send. We did hear the verses. But you know what? That's it, too late. We got reminder, another reminder, another reminder. We never ever changed. So I am here to tell myself to change. May Allah help me to change, to become a better person. And I am here to remind my beloved brothers and sisters, you know what? Our time is ticking. We are not becoming any younger. We have to become disciplined people. We have to leave the sins. We have to obey Allah's instruction. The losers are those who concentrate on what Allah took away. The winners are those who say, Allahu Akbar, Allah took away from me one thing, He still has bestowed me with another million things. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every one of us. And my brothers and sisters, something very important. We have little children. We have people who look up to us. It is about time we became true leaders for our own children. How many of us, we have children who look up to us, but we are leading a life of embarrassment. We are leading a life where we are not even leaders for our own children. If they were to look at us and what we do, they would actually be led astray. We can't let that happen. We need to thank Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. May Allah grant us goodness. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.